بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی آنریبل ڈاکٹر عارف علوی پریزیڈنٹ اسلامک ریپبلک آف پاکستان سینیٹر ولید اقبال پروفیسر ڈاکٹر انیس احمد وائس چانسلر رفاع یونیورسٹی ایکسیلنسیز ڈسٹنگوش گیسٹ اسپیکرز members of the administration and faculty and dear students, assalamu alaikum and a very good morning. I welcome you all to the second international conference on Allama Muhammad Iqbal. I am especially grateful to the honorable president for sparing his valuable time and being with us on this occasion. Topic for today's conference, that is Iqbal's multidimensional wisdom, his vision for social, scientific, and technological revival of the Ummah has been chosen to highlight that Allama Iqbal not only wanted social and spiritual revival of the Ummah, but also wanted them to acquire technical and scientific knowledge. Ladies and gentlemen, Berhia University is committed to spread Iqbal's much admired teachings to youth and Muslim Ummah through organizing conferences, guest lectures, and publications. This conference is a continuity of the same efforts, and I am pleased to share that it is being attended by all campuses of Berhia University in Islamabad, Lahore, and Karachi, besides a large audience on the web. Today, we live in an age of information and social media. Our youth are exposed to Western civilization and way of life, which at times mesmerizes them, but is at variance with our culture and religious ethos. Hence, our motivation to promote Iqbal's message is to guide our youth to the true path through Iqbal's inspiring poetry, which is a true reflection of the Quranic principles. Iqbal says, اپنی ملت پر قیاس اقوام مغرب سے نہ کر خاص ہے ترکیب میں قوم رسول ہاشمی. Universality of Iqbal's message has been acknowledged around the globe and remains a source of inspiration for those who seek true success in this life and the life hereafter. In his literary works, Iqbal highlights clash between materialism and spiritualism. In his opinion, revival of the East lies in spiritualism. Ladies and gentlemen, Iqbal was a visionary who gave the idea of a separate homeland for the Muslims of the subcontinent. Though his primary addressees were the Muslims of Indian subcontinent, but his larger concern was the debilitating condition of the Muslim Ummah itself. He wanted Muslims to come out of stagnation and adapt to the changing global environment. Through his poetry, he said, Aayne nau se darna, tarze kohon pe adna, manzil yahi kathan hai, qaumo ki zindagi mein. Iqbal had great expectations from the youth. In his poetry, youth were highlighted as the greatest wealth and strength of any nation, which immensely contributed to nation building. Iqbal could see the energy in youth required for reaching greater heights to become a strong nation. He firmly believed that it would be the youth who will understand and follow his message. To the youth, he said, Ukabi ruh jab bedar hoti hai jawano mein, nazar aati hai unko apni manzil aasmano mein. Ladies and gentlemen, Iqbal also wanted Muslims to acquire technical knowledge and excel in all walks of life. He clearly stated that the nation which leads in technology leads the world. Muslim Ummah in its golden days was also leading in science and technology. Iqbal, through his poetry, has motivated us to do continuous research so as to lead the world. While emphasizing the need for acquiring technical knowledge, he said, "Nadaan, adab o falsafa kuch cheez nahi hai. Asbaab-e-hunar ke liye lazim hai tagodaw. Fitrat ke nawamis pe ghalib hai hunarmand. Sham iski hai manind-e sahar sahib-e-parto." In the end, I would like to once again thank the Honorable President, Excellencies, distinguished guests and speakers for sparing their precious time and joining us on this occasion. Your kind presence has given us great motivation and strong sense of purpose towards this important cause. I must also applaud the efforts of Iqbal Chair and organizers for making this conference a reality. And I am confident that proceedings of this conference would become a source of guidance for academia and policymakers. We aim to continue our efforts towards promoting teachings of Allama Muhammad Iqbal and hope to see a positive change in our youth and the society at large. I thank you.